Before watching the video, don't forget to subscribe the channel and enable bell notification to never miss an update from us.
Hello everyone and welcome. This is Ashima and in this segment, we'll be talking about daily news events or daily current affairs. Now, this is a daily segment where we update you about the latest news events. Right, we talk about the latest news events over here and we'll be having a look at all of those news events as of now, but the discussion is going to be more of a descriptive type. That is, it is going to benefit all the examination aspirants because we'll be talking about the news event rather than bringing in questions to picture. Right, so for all of you who want to practice the questions also, you can take up everyday quiz on entry app or you can join us on weekend session. Right, we have an everyday weekend every weekend we have a session that happens on Saturday. You can join us there for daily for the week practice of current affairs in form of questions. Right, so that is for your question part, but for this video we'll be talking more about in a descriptive format. That is, we'll be talking about the news event over here. Right, so beginning with the news events, the first is management report of National Park and Wildlife Sanctuaries. Now, this report has recently been released by Union Minister of Environment, Prakash Javedkar. Now, first of all, this is important that who is the Union Minister of Environment. Now, he has released this report of wildlife sanctuaries and park, and according to that, the top five national parks are important, that being top was Jaldapura National Park of West Bengal, then Raiganj Wildlife Sanctuary and Tirthan Wildlife Sanctuary and Sinj Wildlife Sanctuary of Himachal Pradesh and Great Himalayan National Park. These are the top five national parks and wildlife sanctuaries according to the report which was released by the Union Minister recently. Now, apart from that, what else was there was the bottom most. Now, when there are top rank, there's going to be bottom rank. So, bottom rank was Turtle Wildlife Sanctuary of UP and Jay Prakash Narayan Bird Sanctuary of UP. Both of them were the bottom most rank. Now, as for the key findings for this, apart from the top five and the bottom most, there are around 60% of leopard population, 70% of Asiatic lions, 70% of global tiger, and these three are the main reason why these national parks and wildlife sanctuaries are actually thriving. We have seen that it is reported in the leopard census, in the tiger census, that number of or the population of tigers is comparatively increasing. Population of leopard is comparatively increasing. So that increases the reason why national parks and wildlife sanctuaries are thriving in India as per the reports that were stated over here. Now, if we talk about how many protected areas are there in India, there are about 903 protected areas in the country, which around constitute to 5% of the geographical area, total geographical area we are talking about here. So 5% of the total geographical area of India, that is 903 protected areas, that covers all of it. Now, what are the updates for the coming segment? Now, from 2021, there is going to be a ranking of national parks and wildlife sanctuaries also. So, what kind of ranking is going to be there? There will be listed the 10 best national parks and top 5 zoos, top 5 coastal and marine parks. All of these three rankings will be released from 2021 so that a comparative study can be done and a healthy competition is brought in the picture of national parks and wildlife sanctuaries. So to bring in a healthy picture, all of this is going to be done. Now, moving ahead to Tsar Icicle. Now, Tsar Icicle has come to news after it broke down recently. So, first of all, what is Tsar Icicle? Vilyuchinsky Waterfall in winter season is called Tsar Icicle. Right, so it is in Russia, first of all. In which country it is? It is in Russia, in Kamchatka Peninsula, and its name is Vilyuchinsky Waterfall. Now, when this waterfall freezes in winter, then it becomes an icicle. Because what is an icicle? An icicle is a spike of ice which is formed when water falling from an object freezes. That is, as the waterfall is there, it freezes as it is, and the falling direction only. So that is an icicle, and that is formed because of the waterfall. So waterfall's name is important, where is it, that is important, and what is the name of the icicle, that is important. Fourth question can be, what is an icicle? Fifth is, where is it located? That is Kamchatka Peninsula, and it collapsed, killing 4 tourists over there. right? Because of the collapse of this icicle, 4 tourists were dead. Now, there is something which is associated with the term. Now, Winchesky Waterfall is located in the Ring of Fire region. This is located in the Ring of Fire region. Right. Now, what is the Ring of Fire region? It is like in the rim of Pacific Ocean. About 75% of Earth's volcanoes occur in that Ring of Fire region. That is the reason why it is called Ring of Fire, because there's this, if you line around the Pacific Ocean or on the rim of Pacific Ocean, 75% of waterfall volcanoes of the world can be sighted. Now, it has oceanic trenches also, it has movements of plates also, it has volcanic arcs also, and 80% of the world's largest earthquakes, they occur in the Ring of Fire region, right? That is why this region is important, that is Ring of Fire region is important, in which ocean it is, that is it is in Pacific Ocean, that is important, and the questions related to this icicle are also important. Next, data on retail and inflation, retail inflation and factory output was released recently. So what data has been released? First of all, who has released it? It has been released by Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation, or MOSPI. So MOSPI has recently released these rankings. Now, in this, the retail inflation was measured and the factory output was measured. Now, retail inflation is measured via consumer price index. So, this is for retail inflation. Now, this has eased to 4.59% in December 2020. In November, it was 6.93%. From 6.93%, it has dropped to 4.59%. And in December, when the CPI data, if you remember, the annual policy or bi-monthly policy was released of RBI, in that they had stated that CPI has to be kept in a range of 4 with a plus 2 or minus 2 range. So, successfully, it has been done. That was a target of India and that has come to it. Now, second is the factory output. Factory output is in terms of index of industrial production. This is the factory output, right? And it has contracted by minus 1.9% during the month of November, right? And how has this decline been seen? Because mining sector saw a decline, because electricity sector saw a decline, and the manufacturing sector saw a decline. All of them have dropped down, and that is the reason why this has also dropped down. Now, consumer price index is quite more important. It measures the price change from the perspective of a retail buyer, that how amount is changed from perspective of retail buyer, and it is released by National Statistical Officer. Consumer price index is released by NSO, National Statistical Office. Now, CPI is into 5 categories. There are 5 categories of what, or you can say 5 types of consumer price index. Now, 3 are working class specific, that being CPI industrial workers, CPI agricultural laborers, rural laborers. All of these are for working people's perspective, right? So these are released by Labor Bureau. Labor Bureau releases this one. Then we have these 2, CPI urban and CPI rural. Both of them are released by NSO. Right. So these are the 5 categories, out of which 3 are from labor and 2 are from National Statistical Office. Now, base year is also different for all of them. How is it different for them? That is a CPI IW, that is industrial workers. This has the base year of 2016. Earlier it was 2001, but now it has been changed to 2016. And for AL and RL, agriculture and rural labors, it is going to be revised. But as of now, it is of 1986-87. Right? Alright, now moving to the next one. A few one-liners for all of you. Union Cabinet has approved India-UAE Memorandum of Understanding for Scientific and Technical Cooperation. This MOU has been signed between UAE and India to promote the exchange of information, exchange of knowledge, data sharing from satellites, from radars, from gauges, and exchange of technical information, exchange of scientific information, all the meteorological observations, everything, exchange of all of that seismic data also, tsunami early warning center also, all the exchange is going to happen under this MOU. So this MOU is very, very important. Then Cherry Blossom Mao Festival was held recently in Manipur. This is a very important festival of Manipur, and it has been asked multiple times in questions last year. So it is important for the part. And then Pakistan government has issued a special permission to Dubai royal family members, allowing them to hunt the internationally protected bird Hubra Bustard during 2021 hunting session. And this Hubra Bustard is under vulnerable category. So it is under vulnerable category, but still they have, Pakistan government has allowed the Dubai royal family to do the hunting. Okay, it is vulnerable under IUCN listing. Right. Now, with this, we'll be winding up the segment. Thank you so much. It has been a wonderful interaction with all of you, and we'll see you in the upcoming segment on Saturday with all the question round. Until then, goodbye, take care, and have a wonderful day ahead.